I had the privilege to co-organize the Lowe Syndrome Research Meeting held in Pozzuoli last May after more than 10 years working on Lowe syndromes. The meeting gathered researcher, clinician, patients association and patients and gave a wide and complete view of on Lowe syndrome.
I don't think we've ever had a research meeting where we've had everyone in one place like this. So that was really special.
For me, the highlights were meeting the dedicated researchers and families of young men and boys with Lowe syndrome. It's really awe-inspiring to see such a dedicated group.
I thought it was really important that we have a session dedicated to the patient advocacy groups and patient representatives at the research meeting, because they become really the experts in their rare disease and researchers can learn a lot from interacting with them. Also, we have the ambition to move some of the small molecules that have been identified towards clinical trials. And to do that, we are going to have to work in close partnership with the patient groups. I think it's really important that the outputs of research and how we go about what we're doing is shared with as wide a variety of people as possible, particularly the people that are affected.
I think it's very important to have someone with lived experience, because people, professionals, can learn a lot from people with lived experience.
It was a chance for all of us to see all the various research that's happening around the globe for Lowe syndrome, which was really amazing. Learned of some new research, and it's going to allow us to really decide where to focus our research dollars in the future.
As for other rare disease, the possibility to get big fundings from government or from charities and so on would be a great help in the study of Lowe syndrome.
The amount of money that goes into the research is proportional, or would be proportional, to the output. The goal, of course, is to find novel treatments. If we had unlimited funding, that research would be accomplished faster.
Because in this way, we could combine basic preclinical and clinical research to develop new tools, new models, and new therapies to study and to treat Lowe syndrome.
The money is the driving force behind success.
This really is a blueprint for future meetings, and it really showed that this type of blueprint makes for a better meeting overall, a more holistic approach. We have a rare disease on our hands here, and we are sort of an extended family, and so I think really trying to find a way for everyone to participate in any event that we have, to the extent possible, I think is super special.